about this house. It is over 100 years old, and this is our plaque right here if you'd like to take a photograph of that. Now, she bought it in 1919 for $800, had it all decorated and paid off in 2 weeks. Right when she bought it, alcohol was illegal. All of these houses, all the way up to Park Avenue, these were all bootlegging bordellos that had trap doors. These other girls would smuggle in homemade whiskey. This stuff was called rot gut for a good reason. It would eat out your liver and kill you. And if you did die, the girl did not care. Worst thing she would do is pick all your pockets, toss you right over the handrail. You went down the creek, you were somebody else's problem. Now, Dolly, she would smuggle in through a trap door underneath the bar in the hallway Canadian whiskey. A young man made $1 a day back then, so you're lucky. She would charge 50 cents for half a shot, $2 the full glass, $3 was a visit. Around town, they called it the Carpenter Special, hammered and nailed for $5. Now, her occupation, that closed down permanently by 1954. Well, she continued to work by herself in the house until 1960. She was 72 years old when she did retire. So, the tall photo there on the wall, that was done in World War II, 55 years old, about 30 in the white one. That little one was about 13 or 14. Now, Dolly never got married, she never had children. Her money funded an orphanage on the island. It also funded our animal welfare shelter, and that is still operating today. She passed away in 1975. She was almost 88 years old. She was worth over $250,000. Left it all to this house to become a museum. The only thing not original in the house is the bedroom wallpaper upstairs. Now, you can take photographs or video throughout the whole house. Remember, go into the bathroom upstairs. Be sure you get a picture of him in front of that shower curtain upstairs, okay? Look at the top of it. It looks like it's decorated with old silk flowers. Well, here's your history lesson for the day. They're not silk flowers, they're silk condoms. They were actually made for Civil War soldiers by a Frenchman that had been sent over from France. And his name was Jean Le Condom, and he was from Le Condom, France. Now, Dolly knew they would not work, but they were very pretty, so she used them for decoration instead. And I really don't think Martha Stewart would be that creative. So have fun. Take pictures. If you have any questions about anything, come back down. If you all had a good time, leave a bit of a tip in my office or right down here. I do volunteer, and that's how I make my money. Okay, right through the doors. Enjoy.
instead of a saloon band. Down by the river side.
Thank you. You really do, you know, you got me so.